What's up, people? Joe Winko here, your favorite Hawaiian guy. And today, I'm going to be exploring the town of Claremont, Florida. Yeah, the thing is, I couldn't really find a welcome to Claremont sign. I even tried asking at some of the places we stopped at, but no one really knew where a welcome to Claremont sign was. They did say there's a few Claremont city limits sign. So what brought me to Claremont, Florida is a while ago, I was talking to my adoptive parents about how I really wanted to live in Ocala, Florida, because it's away from the water and it's safe from storm surge, and also because it's not too crowded or too populated either. My adoptive parents do like Ocala, but they think that it would be better if I lived in Claremont, Florida instead. He said that it was really hilly and really mountainous here. I definitely noticed them when we were going around Claremont, and I thought it was really interesting seeing all that because I always thought that Florida was just really flat. But even on Interstate 75, when you're going through Florida, it is very hilly, and the hills are quite impressive. Also, Claremont, Florida actually has less people than Ocala, and way less people than the town in Florida I live in. I don't really like towns that are too crowded and too congested because, first of all, the traffic is really bad, and it's not very fun if you're a biker, like me. Another thing I noticed is Claremont doesn't really seem to have any loud motorcycle riders like in Pasco County. I'm very happy about that. However, the road behind me, Florida State Route 50, it is pretty loud right now, but that's only because it's 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock, which are the rush hour hours. Yeah, rush hour is never just 1 hour. Remember that, especially down here in Florida. I also never been to this town before, and I'm also not familiar with it at all either. But in all honesty, that just makes it even more exciting because, as you all know, I love seeing new places and I love adventure, especially when I get to film YouTube videos at them too. I'm actually here with my adoptive parents right now, and I'm going to be exploring some parts of Claremont, Florida in this video, and I hope you guys all like them. So let's get this party started. So in all honesty, I actually did not plan any of the locations I was going to show you guys in Claremont, Florida. Me and my adoptive parents sort of just drove up here to explore, like kind of on a whim. But there is one cool thing I wanted to show you guys, and it's actually the first thing I noticed right when we arrived in Claremont. This lake right here. So this lake is called Center Lake, and really it looks a lot bigger on the map for some reason. That's what I kind of thought, but it doesn't really seem that big once you're there. The really cool thing about it is they have a fountain right in the middle of the lake, and I thought that was really awesome how they got that all the way out there like that. There's also more stuff around here too. Let me show it to you guys right now. My adoptive dad pointed these out earlier. These trees right behind me, these are cypress trees, and they're actually not allowed to be cut down at all. I didn't know that, but they're not allowed to be cut down. Probably for some environmental rules or something like that. And of course, we also have my personal favorite, the palm trees. And another thing my adopted dad said about Claremont, Florida, he told me that there's a lot of islanders living around Claremont, Florida, and that if I ever moved to Claremont, Florida, I would fit in here perfectly fine. I haven't really noticed that so much yet, but I'll see what I find around here. But overall, it is a really beautiful lake though. I'm actually surprised that they don't have a park set up near it. I didn't really notice it at all when I was looking around this area, but there's no picnic tables or anything. However, I did see some stuff right here. There is a bench. That's what I see. But besides that, well, actually, there's two benches. Let me show them to you guys. They're right that way, right across from the lake. And there's also another one further down there. But overall, it is a really cool lake with a really awesome fountain in it and an awesome landmark to Claremont too. So let me show you guys some more. Okay, so here's another place in Claremont, Florida that I wanted to show you guys just for comparison reasons. This is a busy highway that runs through Florida. This behind me is Florida State Route 50. It's not a federal highway, it's a state highway because it runs exclusively through the state of Florida. However, it's still connected to all the other roads. Otherwise, I would have had no way of getting here. So let me show you guys some of the traffic on this road. So as you see right now on Florida State Route 50, there are quite a few cars driving down this road, but earlier, like a couple minutes ago, I didn't really notice that many cars. The road seemed pretty empty. It wasn't exactly empty because there were a few people driving on it. However, in the town in Florida that I live in, the roads are always busy, and it's not a safe place for bikers either because they don't watch for bikers at all. But overall, so far, the town doesn't seem very crowded. I'm standing right in front of a Cracker Barrel. Yep, this town actually has one too. Right here, my adoptive parents and I just finished eating there. They have good food. I love Cracker Barrel. My adoptive mom always wants to eat at Cracker Barrel whenever we're on a road trip. It's kind of like a tradition, really. That's what we did on the way down to Florida back in January of 2016. It's also feeling a bit chilly here. And look at this. The trees also have Spanish moss on them too. Not quite as much as Ocala, but all I found was that. So as you see, not as much as that park in Ocala that I went to a long time ago. This place is definitely different from Ocala. It gives off a different vibe. It's really hilly too. And it's also getting a bit chilly here. Like, it's not really sunny. It's kind of dreary, but that's just the weather. I'm 100% sure that Claremont, Florida has tons of sunny, warm days. Because it's Florida, why wouldn't it? While me and my adoptive parents were driving around, we found another really cool thing to show you guys here in Claremont, Florida. Usually people always think that Florida is really flat and that it doesn't have any hills or mountains or anything like that. But that's incorrect because look behind me and look at this. Look at all that. Let me show you guys a closer look. So that's the view from this hill in Claremont, Florida. Look how far that goes. And plus you can see a lake down there. I didn't really notice the lake at first, and I'm not exactly sure what it's called, but I'll have it typed on the screen somewhere if I figure it out. And there's a lot of huge houses around too. And one of those houses even has solar panels on the roof. I remember a long time ago, this one friend I was talking to told me that houses in Florida aren't allowed to have solar panels on the roof at all, but that's actually not true at all. Lots of people in Florida actually do have solar panels on their roofs. Like in this one town that I live in Florida, there's like this whole street of people who have solar panels on their roofs. It's just that I didn't notice it until much later for some reason. And another thing is, I heard that if you save up a lot of power from the solar panels, like you can actually sell it back to the electric company and they pay you for it. And I thought that was really cool and really awesome. My adoptive dad recommended this place because he said it had really high elevation on the Floridian Peninsula and that flooding wouldn't be much of an issue here in Claremont. If you're not in a low-lying area, it wouldn't be an issue. And you know, the funny thing is, I was looking up Claremont on Google because I wanted to see if I could find out the exact elevation of Claremont. And when I first typed it into Google, Google told me that Claremont was 3,000 feet above sea level, and I was like, what? In Florida? But turns out that actually wasn't Claremont, Florida. That was like, I think it was Claremont, Idaho or something like that. I was about to say.
It was actually a town called Claremont, Wyoming that I ended up finding on accident because I misspelled Claremont, Florida. I was pretty sure that it was a mistake right away because I'm 100% certain that no town in the state of Florida is more than 3,000 feet above sea level. That would just be crazy. But imagine if it was.
However, Claremont, Florida is 300 feet above sea level. And that was very interesting. I didn't think areas in Florida were that high above sea level. And I was pretty certain that no place in Florida is 3,000 feet above sea level. But it's really cool nonetheless. Take me away, a secret place, a secret place. Sweetest guest, take me away, take me away, take me away, to better days, to better days. Take me away, take me away, a hiding place, a hiding place. Take me away, a secret place, a secret place, a sweetest guest, a sweetest guest. Take me away, take me away, take me away, take me away, to better days, to better days. Take me away, take me away, a hiding place, a hiding place. There's a place that I go that nobody knows, where the rivers flow and I call it home. And there's no more lies in the darkness is light and nobody cries, there's only butterflies.
All right, so right now I'm actually at one of Claremont's Florida's most famous landmarks, the Florida Citrus Tower. As you can see, it's right behind me, and the thing is pretty big. Let me tell you some more about this building. This building was built in 1956, and the whole purpose of this building was to allow visitors to get a good view of all the orange groves in Florida. According to Wikipedia, the building itself is 226 feet tall. And it's also on top of a mountain. The antenna on the top of the building is actually 500 feet above sea level. It also used to be one of the most famous landmarks in the state of Florida. And to this very day, it remains the tallest vantage point in the entire state of Florida. Let me show you guys a closer look one second. Okay. So right there is the entrance and the gift shop, and all the way up there is the top. Yeah, this thing is gigantic, 226 feet tall. This thing is actually taller than the Skyway Bridge. Definitely wouldn't survive a fall off of that. You actually can go up there, but it costs $6 to go up there. And another thing is, it's only open from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., so it's closed right now. It's a really beautiful building, but I kind of get an unsettling feeling being around it. I haven't done an episode of Joe Winko Talk about this specific topic yet, but for those of you who don't know, I kind of have a phobia. I believe it's pronounced megalophobia. It's a fear of extremely large objects. Quite a few people have it, and there's actually a whole section on Reddit that's dedicated to scary pictures of large objects that freak people out who have that phobia. I absolutely do have megalophobia. However, my form of megalophobia is I'm only afraid of large objects that move, like cruise ships and airplanes. Airplanes scare the heck out of me. Cruise ships, they make me feel really uneasy when I'm staring at them. But once I'm inside of them, I'm not afraid of them at all. But when I'm seeing them from the outside, they freak me out. I'm not afraid of trucks or buses at all, and I'm rarely ever afraid of buildings, as you guys saw in Mobile, Alabama, and Charlotte, North Carolina. However, the Sears Tower in Chicago kind of freaks me out because I kind of associate that tower with suffering because I ran away to Chicago once a long time ago, but that's a whole nother story. This building kind of does give me the chills, but overall, it's a beautiful building and I absolutely love it. I also love how they have the orange stripes running down it because, as you all know, I have a mild form of autism, and one thing autism causes is it causes people to be very sensitive to colors. Like, autistic people are very sensitive to light and colors, and I'm very sensitive to bright, saturated colors, which is why this building stood out to me, because of the orange on it. And I really thought that was a nice touch, because the whole purpose of this building was to view the orange groves also. And most of all, it is also on top of a mountain. Yes, Florida really does have mountains. There's actually no specific height or measurement a landform has to be in order for it to be classified as a mountain. However, according to dictionary.com, the definition for a mountain is a large natural elevation of the Earth's surface rising abruptly from the surrounding level, a large steep hill. The landform that this tower is built on is definitely a large steep hill. People always think that Florida is really flat, but that's not true. Florida has a lot of hills, and it even has mountains too. Even in the peninsula. I'm standing on one right now. Overall, it is a really beautiful building. I wouldn't want to live inside of it because I am kind of afraid of heights, but it's not a residential building at all, so I don't have to worry about that. But whatever. Let me show you guys a view from this particular mountain that I'm actually standing on right now. So I'm standing on top of this mountain in Claremont, Florida, and let me show you guys the view. There it is. Now, it may not look very high on the video, but if you have ever been here and actually looked and saw how high this really is, you would be amazed, because people always say that Florida is really flat and that there's no hills or mountains, but look at this. We're so high up. This almost reminds me of something out of Montana, except with palm trees. It's absolutely beautiful though. I even remember reading on this one website that literally every state in the USA has mountains. Florida definitely has mountains too, because I'm standing on one right now. That is actually a major thing that draws me to Claremont, Florida, because people always talk about how the polar ice caps are melting and the sea level is rising. However, I think that if all the polar ice water melted, Claremont, Florida would not be underwater. It would become an island, like Hawaii. They would have interstates going into the ocean. Interstate 75 would go into the ocean. Interstate 95 would go into the ocean. That'd be a really interesting thing to look at, too. Gosh. But seriously, I honestly think Claremont, Florida really would not be underwater if all the polar ice caps melted. I remember reading on one website that the scientists believe that if all the ice water in the polar caps melted, that would raise the sea level by roughly 200 feet, I believe. However, if it would rise by 200 feet if all the polar ice water melted, Claremont would still be above sea level because Claremont's elevation is roughly 300 feet. Awesome, isn't it? So not all Florida would be lost.
Sun is on my side. Take me for a ride. I smile up to the sky. I know I'll be all right. The sun is on my side. Take me for a ride. I smile up to the sky. I know I'll be all right.
So right now I'm at my last stop in Claremont, Florida. Right behind me is Lake Mineola. This lake is massive, not quite as massive as Lake Michigan and Wisconsin or any of the Great Lakes, but still massive nonetheless. And if you guys look way over there, you can actually see a pier that goes out into the lake. That's not the only pier too. There's actually a whole walking trail along this lake. But I don't really feel like walking it right now because it's getting kind of chilly out here. Yeah, the sun is starting to set too. You can't really see it very well though because it's kind of cloudy out. It's a beautiful lake, but in all honesty, I wouldn't really feel comfortable living very close to it. The only reason why is because I'm concerned with storm surge risk in case a really powerful hurricane rolls along this area. Most of the time, storm surge is known to come from the ocean. However, I do remember one hurricane making landfall in southern Florida, and it caused storm surge from Lake Okeechobee in Florida, and I've heard that it was really bad. I don't exactly remember what year that is, but it was not good. However, this lake isn't nearly as large as Lake Okeechobee, because you can literally see Lake Okeechobee from outer space. They also play a lot of live music in that bar, like way over there. So if you hear someone playing a guitar and singing, that's what it is. Overall, I'm honestly really impressed with Claremont, Florida. I had no idea that the state of Florida had mountains. Like everyone else, I thought that the state of Florida was just some flat peninsula, but it actually has a really interesting landscape, really. It does have hills and it does have mountains, just like every state in the USA. You learn something new every day. So that's basically it for my adventure of exploring Claremont, Florida. I hope you guys all liked this video. It was a lot of fun. I loved Claremont, Florida. It was awesome. And let me know, what was your favorite place I showed you guys in Claremont, Florida? And what did you think of this video? And have you ever been to Claremont, Florida? And have you ever lived in Claremont, Florida? And what do you think of Claremont, Florida? Make sure to leave a comment and let's get a conversation started, because as I explained many times, that's the whole point of my videos. Don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to like me on Facebook and follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr. So that's it. Peace out, people.